Welcome to this Liverpool Fan TV. This is preview for our game against Flamengo, and we will also talk about rest of the game in EPL predictions. But first, the biggest game on the planet, as Klopp will tell us, it's game against Flamengo, the Club World Cup final, big game. And the best thing is that VVD is back fit, and he's expected to play, so that will sort few things out. It will put forward Hendo in the midfield, and I think Ox and Keita will partner him in the midfield, or probably if Gini is fit, Gini, Hendo and Keita can play, and our front three will start mostly. The last game saw a lot of changes, and we looked like a team which had made a lot of changes. We have been making changes entire December game, starting from Everton, but we still did not lose our identity and intensity, as we call it as. But last game was bit intensity was bit dropped, and they have traveled a lot and played a lot already, so that could have taken toll. But I'm expecting big match tomorrow and big performance from our team, and as I said, Van Dijk back is a big plus. I think along with Mane, this season has been our best player. Even I would have called Fabinho as well, but he's injured, so let's not put pressure on him. Van Dijk and Mane, and Alisson was man of the match in the last game, no doubt about that. He kept us in the game, and he did that against Watford too. So that will be my team prediction. Like, Alisson will start in the goal, and back four of Gomez, Van Dijk, Robbo and Tah. Tah did not started, and Mane, Firmino also did not started. But once they were all three were called upon, we looked totally different side. We looked like a Liverpool side, and thank God Firmino got goal in the normal time. Otherwise, I did not wanted extra time. It would have added burden to us. So that's great that we finished the game in normal 90 minute of play. So in midfield, as I already said, Hendo will be anchoring them. And if Gini is fit, he will play. Otherwise, Ox will play. And Keita will start. He is becoming vital because his late run towards the box, and in the number 10 position, whole around the midfielder, he comes into his own. His link up play with Salah, his co striking, he gets away, he takes a yard or two, he makes a yard for himself, he makes a deep run, and he scores or create chances. In that zone, he comes into his own. You could tell why Klopp wanted him, because he gives extra. In the number 10 position, he's second to none. His build-up, his pass, his shot is second to none in our midfield, and he adds a different dynamic. So he will start, no doubt about that. And front three will start, because we cannot take Flamengo lightly. We haven't won that, and I think we have lost three matches in our last four games against Brazilian team. So it's going to be a massive game. And I predict a 3-1 win. It's going to be tight, but at the end, our quality will show up, and we will be world champion. And that's my team prediction and score prediction. I'll run through all the results. Everton versus Arsenal. I predicted Everton win before Mikel Arteta was unveiled, and after hearing his interview, not gonna lie, he impressed me, and he looked like honest guy. He has hearts on his sleeve, and he addressed all the situations. So I think that will give boost to the players. And if there is a not draw and Arsenal lose, I don't know. They have to change their entire team. I think only 4 or 5 players, and their young kids are good enough to play in the Arsenal anyway. So they need to make all such changes. And I am predicting draw. Newcastle Crystal Palace. I think Newcastle will win. Steve Bruce has done wonderful job. Even though I don't like him, but I have to say that he has done commendable job, and he deserves every plaudits he is getting now, and he will win. Aston Villa Southampton. Somehow Southampton are not able to finish the game, not able to take points. even a single point, they still managed to lose the game, even though they are in a strong position or they played well. So I think Aston Villa will win. Norwich Wolves, I think my head says Wolves will win, but my heart says it will be a draw, because Norwich will give everything. They have given everything against Leicester, but playing football against Wolves can be different proposition. So still I'll go with draw, even though my head says that Wolves will win. I'll go with draw. Brighton, Sheffield United. Brighton will try to play football, and Sheffield United will try to stifle them and play on a counter, or as they liked, their center back going bombing on the wings. I think Sheffield United will win. They haven't lost game away, and I think they will win. Bournemouth, Burnley, it will be a draw. The both team are conscious of getting dragged into bottom three, so they will try to play safe, and it will be draw. Man City, Leicester, along with Spurs, Chelsea, probably game of the weekend. In the EPL, of course, biggest game of the weekend is Club World Cup final. We all know that. But Manchester City, Leicester, I don't know. It could go either way, so I have gone for draw. If Manchester City turn up and they play the way they play against Arsenal, even though Arsenal let them play, but still, if they can play the game, or even the way they played against us, I think they will win. But Leicester can hurt them on the counter, so I have gone for draw. Watford, Man United. Watford will try to play football game against Man United, and whichever team tried to put their game plan on them, they have always Man United done well. We also tried to impose our game, and they got draw against us, and they have defeated United, Chelsea, City, Tottenham, and I think they got very credible draw against Arsenal as well. So I think Man United will win against Watford. Spurs, Chelsea, I think Spurs will win. Chelsea are stuttering, and Mourinho is flying, so I think Spurs will win. That's my prediction, and looking forward for game against tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.